Hello everyone, how are you doing today? I've been doing well. Alright, so in this video, you're gonna watch, yes, The Secret Life of Pets 2, 2019. I hope you enjoy it. It's a really lovely movie. I like it. I watched it. It was amazing. So, let's gonna watch a portion, learn some vocabulary. Everyday new movie, as I told you. So, subscribe to the YouTube channel and make sure that you are a big fan of this. Let's watch.
And eventually, he started crawling. Sort of. And suddenly, my own home wasn't safe anymore. There was a tiny monster taking it over. Now, I did my best to keep a safe distance. Then one day, Liam did something I never expected.
Mats! I love you, Mats.
And from then on, everything was different. Duke and I, we became like role models to him. Like, what can I say? The kid's a fan. We try to be a good influence. And we help him out whenever we can. This kid gets us. Yeah, we have fun. And by the way, I'm still not a kid person. I'm talking about this kid. This is my kid. He's perfect. And I'm never gonna let anything bad happen to him. But I gotta say, keeping Liam safe.
Let's get back to business. Or let's get down to business. Let's start learning some vocabulary. Okay, some things are easy just to notice. You don't have to explain that much. So from then on, this means from that day, you know, now we have been friends since that day or from then on. Right, sort of, or sort of, it's kind of, okay, means a little, like, you know, not like big, but a little. As you can see, you notice that from the movie. We have here also, this kid gets us means understands us, right? Gonna is a short form of going to. Alright, this is informal. Don't use that in writing. Don't say gonna. You're gonna say I'm going to in writing, okay? A kid person means a person who loves kid a lot. Or loves kids. Loves get kids a lot. Alright, a person who loves kids a lot. Eventually. Adverb. At the end of a period of time or series of events. Events. Our flight eventually left 5 hours late. She hopes eventually to attend medical school and become a doctor. Use finally for the last in a list of things. So this is the last thing you're going to say. Finally, I'd like to thank my parents. You don't say eventually, I'd like to thank my parents in your email or writing, right? You don't say that. You don't say eventually, no. When you are talking about series of things, all right, you just use better to use finally at the end of your series of things. So eventually, at the end of a period of time or series of events, our flight eventually left. She hopes eventually to attend. And we use finally for the last in a list of things. Crawling, right? It's crawling. It's a verb that takes ing. So the original verb is crawl, to crawl. So put ing, it becomes crawling. To move forward on your hands and knees with your body close to the ground. Our baby is just starting to crawl. Intransitive, you can add adverb or preposition. To move forward very slowly. The traffic was crawling along, was very slowly. The weeks crawled by. You feel like so bored, you know? Crawl to somebody, it's informal and disapproving. This means to be too friendly or helpful to somebody in authority, especially authority, in a way that is not sincere, especially in order to get an advantage from them. She's always crawling to the boss. I'm trying to be kind and nice and all right, and this is not her person anyway, but she's trying to imitate someone or something to get advantage of the situation, maybe a promotion or something, but sneaking, you know? Not good character, not good person. Come or come out, crawl out of the woodwork. This is also informal, disapproving. If you say that somebody comes or crawls out of the woodwork, you mean that they have suddenly appeared in order to express an opinion or take advantage of the situation. When he won the lottery, all sorts of distant relatives came out of the woodwork. So his relatives don't usually visit him. But when he wants a lot of money, he has a big money. He has a lot of money, all right? I'm going to get advantage of that. Hey, how are you doing? We miss you. And so on. But this is does not normally happen. Suddenly, adverb. Quickly and unexpectedly. We took expected, what it means, in the last few episodes. I suddenly realized what I had to do. I suddenly became aware of just how late it was. She became ill and died suddenly at her home because of coronavirus. Role model. A person you always wanted to be like him or her, or like them. A person that people admire and try to copy everything of him. His haircut, his clothes, his everything to copy. We need positive role models for young women to aspire, or we need positive role models for young men to aspire to. Fan, noun. A person who admires somebody or something, or enjoys watching or listening to somebody or something very much. Sports, music fans. Movie fans will be familiar with his work already. Crowds of football fans filled the streets. Crowds of football fans fill the streets. I like his films, but I wouldn't say I'm a diehard fan. A diehard fan means one who strongly admires everything of somebody, even if that thing's not good. I just like him, I love him, whatever he does, I love him. All right? Fan of somebody or something, you can say that. I'm a big fan of her books, her lifestyle, so on. Blossom. Of a tree or bush to produce blossom. The cherry trees blossomed early this year. And the meaning of the context here is like my life became better, prospered, better, right? So you don't just translate everything typically, all right? You need to put your sense. You need to put your touch. Also, to become more healthy, confident, or successful. She has visibly blossomed over the last few months. Blossom into something. Their friendship blossomed into love. So the friendship starts the beginning, like, you know, you like her and she likes you. Now you blossom into love. This friendship changes and became love. Tenderly, adverb, in a kind, gentle, loving way. She kissed him tenderly. Oh, lucky man. Influence, influence, to have an effect on the way that somebody behaves or thinks, especially by giving him an example to follow. Influence somebody something. His writings have influenced the lives of millions. His writings have influenced the lives of millions. I do not wish to influence your decision one way or the other. Influence somebody in something. Her parents tried to influence her in her choice of university, like convince her. Help out or help somebody out. To help somebody, especially in a difficult situation he has been through or been through. He's always willing to help out. You know, whenever you ask him, he's ready. When I bought the house, my sister helped me out with a loan. She gave me a little bit of money, okay? You take loans from bank, okay? But you can take it also from your friend, sister. A loan is like money, all right? I was only trying to help out. Thank you for watching all this. I hope you enjoyed this class. Subscribe to the YouTube channel, watch more videos, and see you soon.